Hi, I'm Alice Long, a PI at Benaroya Research Institute at Virginia Mason in Seattle, Washington. I'd like to share my take on recent findings from my lab. I study type 1 diabetes. It's an organ-specific autoimmune disease that leads to destruction of the insulin-producing pancreatic islet beta cells. And this loss of beta cells results in glucose dysregulation and a lifelong dependence on insulin therapy. However, there are immune therapies that are currently being tested in clinical trials and have shown some promise. Some have even delayed disease progression. However, we still have a ways to go to understand the immune states that influence the rate of disease progression and to discover how to more specifically target the autoreactive cells destroying the beta cells. And so overall, understanding the immune states of autoreactive cells will inform the treatment, what treatment is best for each individual. And so here, we specifically asked what autoreactive islet-specific CD8 T cells differed in rapid and slow progressors. This question was based on our knowledge that the loss of insulin-producing islet beta cells varies significantly across individuals diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. And in fact, also CD8 T cells play an integral role in disease. And so I want to start with one of our most profound findings. So we identified three phenotypes within autoreactive islet-specific CD8 T cells that were most abundant phenotypes across all individuals that we looked at. These included two transitional memory populations marked by the presence or absence of Helios. In addition, they included EOMS-positive exhausted cells. So all type 1 diabetics had classically defined memory islet-specific cells, which was consistent with other findings. What was really exciting was the striking difference between phenotypes in rapid and slow progressors. In rapid progressors, the islet-specific cells were enriched for a Helios-positive transitional memory population. However, in the slow progressors, the islet-specific CD8 T cells were enriched in EOMS-positive exhausted cells. And so this observation is relatively simple and straightforward. However, these are rare, low-affinity autoreactive cells, and they can be challenging to identify. And so there were really three keys that made our discovery possible. The first was careful selection of a cohort that was defined by extreme disease trajectory, as identified as the rapid and slow progressors. There was also careful development of a high-dimensional sample-sparing CyTOF assay that included tetramer-positive cells. And the third was an analytical workflow that we called DiscovR that phenotypically classifies rare subpopulations. And so importantly, these phenotypes resulted in functional differences in islet-specific cells. So specifically, the subjects enriched for the exhausted islet-specific cells proliferated less, while the subjects, both the Helios-positive and negative subjects that were enriched for memory cells, proliferated more. And in addition, in this manuscript, we also show that this hyporesponsive exhausted state is not entirely caused by age or disease duration. And the presence of exhausted islet-specific CD8 T cells is not disease-specific, since islet-specific CD8 T cells are found in healthy controls. And so taken all together, data in our manuscript suggests several key takeaways that I'd like to share with you. The first is that islet-specific CD8 T cells are not uniform, but instead, they typically include 2 to 5 phenotypes, and these phenotypes differ across individuals. And importantly, these islet-specific immune states distinguish disease trajectory as we described in the rapid and slow progressors. Exhausted cells are prominent in slow progressors, and this suggests that therapies that augment exhaustion may be beneficial. In contrast, depletion of Helios-positive transitional memory cells that are prominent in rapid progressors may be therapeutically beneficial. And so with this knowledge, I really hope that these discoveries will help move the field forward in terms of targeting more aggressive therapies to subjects with rapid disease and helping us in developing more targeted therapies for all subjects with type 1 diabetes. I sincerely thank all the people who contributed to this study, And we all hope you enjoy reading about the details of this study and our manuscript. Thank you very much.